Good morning, everybody.
Are we right to go?
Today, two premiers on the front line of Australia's latest COVID nightmare urged 12 million lockdown Aussies to brace for more restrictions.
It is too early for us to determine whether we'll be able to come out of this lockdown at midnight on Tuesday night.
I'm not going to rule out that there won't be further tweaks.
As Sydneysiders adjust to the harshest lockdown condition yet, the state's cases continue to surge.
Unfortunately, we still had 105 cases of community transmission, and 27 of those cases were infectious in the community, so they were still active in the community.
A further 7 were in the community for part of their infectious period.
And that's the number that worries us the most.
And it isn't budging.
We don't expect to see that number shift massively for the next few days.
While the majority of new cases are from southwest Sydney, authorities are urging Sydneysiders to take this seriously after the state recorded its 4th death linked to the outbreak, a woman in her 90s.
We can't overemphasise that COVID can lead to illness and death, and it can cause deaths in young people.
Frustrations mount as people continue to flout lockdown rules. Most concerning, 3 removalists who knowingly had COVID but still travelled to regional New South Wales.
This is reckless, careless and deliberate, and they'll feel the full brunt of the law.
It comes as Victoria records 17 new cases, worryingly 1 in Mildura.
We take no joy from the fact that there is a case in Mildura today, and that'll require a lot of work.
Tonight, both states remain on a knife edge.
The next 24, 48 hours are critical.
If we all keep working together, we'll get out of this in a timely way.
Epidemiologist Mary Louise McClaws joins us now from Sydney. Professor, what's your take on today's numbers?
Today's numbers, Lisa, look very good. You've got to take it carefully and slowly. But the group of numbers that you look at is everybody that is not in lockdown, hasn't been in full quarantine or isolation. So that proportion of people in the greater Sydney area is plateauing, which is potentially a good sign, because you'd expect that to take at least 7 days, but sometimes up to 14. So I think it's looking good. I am cautiously optimistic.
Professor, today's the first day of the tough new restrictions here in New South Wales. Are the current settings right, do you think?
Well, the current settings would have helped had they been a couple of weeks ago, quite frankly, because then people would get it and they wouldn't interpret some of these recommendations or requests. For example, I still notice that people are not wearing a mask when they're walking their dog or walking, and that's not exercise. So you can still be exhaling particles with virus or inhaling them. So please wear a mask when you leave home. The other thing is that we could be using testing at work sites, for example, so that every time you turn up to a building site or somewhere where you really have to go to work, you should be having a test on site. That would then help for that safety of that work site.
If New South Wales has plateaued, how much longer do you think that the lockdown is likely to last? Give us a prediction, Professor.
Well, I've been saying for the last week at least 3 to 4 weeks, given that I thought we'd get to a peak. We still need another 3 or 4 weeks because we need to get that proportion to zero. And then once we've got that to zero, then we need that to continue for 14 days to ensure that we've mitigated everything. Now, you could lift some small restrictions off, but then you wouldn't be able to lift all of them off until 28 days after that first zero of anybody out in the community that hadn't been in full lockdown. So it's a long duration. So expect another 2 months before we've absolutely eradicated it, but we don't have to stay in lockdown for that long.
Wow. Sorry, Professor. I was just looking at my Sydney colleagues who all looked shocked on the desk when you just said that amount of time.
Yes. It will take at least 4 weeks to get that proportion of people who are not in full isolation to zero. Because as the authorities keep reminding you, and it's true, that everything you're looking at is like being in the Doctor Who TARDIS. You know, you've gone backwards. It's like looking in reverse. And we need that reverse time to catch up for the real time. And so we need to live in zero for at least 14 days to know that we're safe. and then we can start lifting some of the restrictions.
Let's quickly talk about the situation down in Victoria. 17 new cases, but obviously the worrying thing is such large exposure sites. Amy Park, the MCG. Are Victoria at where New South Wales was at a couple of weeks ago, or do you think they are more on top of it?
Look, I think they're more on top of it because there's only about a day and a half between when they find somebody and their exposure period. They went in lockdown on the third day when they had a total of about 14 cases. But quite frankly, any other state or territory, you need to lock down when you had one escape Delta because they are so fast and so fit. But I imagine that Victoria will get ahead of this much faster than we have, because we're in about our, I don't know, 32nd day, and we're up to 1,243 cases. So that's how fast Delta can travel. But I think that Victoria will be in a better place than we've been.
All right, some pretty sobering news there. Mary Louise McClaws, great chatting with you as always.
Stay safe.
Hey guys, some more COVID news. Now, I know Victorian Premier Dan Andrews is trying his best to provide information at the press conferences, right? We can all see that he's trying his best, but this seems like an unreasonable question from this journo.
The government exposure site is down right now. Do you know about that and why?
No, I don't. Probably being updated. Probably getting a whole lot of new information put on it, I would think. I don't know. If it's happened while we're here, we can chase it up for you. We can chase it up for you. You can chase it up. I'm not monitoring the website as I speak to you.
All right. Not good enough, Dan. Eyes on both, please.
With so much content online, it's sometimes hard to keep up with it all. And let's face it, who has the time? The project YouTube has you covered with the stories that matter. Hit subscribe for a daily list of the news that you need to know.